we'll be hearing now about the Newton Fund. We've heard from one of the alumni, and now we will hear about the modalities of this program. So I'm inviting onto the stage our representative from the British Council, Ms. Chanya Tangsuk.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Chanya Tangsuk. I'm a representative from the British Council, and I work on the Newton Fund. So thank you very much, EURAXESS, for having the British Council here to talk about opportunities from the UK. So before I start my presentation, can just a show of hands of those who have not heard of the Newton Fund before? There are a few people. I assume the rest have heard or are familiar with the Newton Fund. So today, the Newton Fund is a very big UK government research funding, and British Council were one of the delivery partners of the Newton Fund. You'll see how it works. So I'm here today to represent 5 out of the 12 programs under the Newton Fund, and you can find the rest, of course, on the website. So introducing the British Council, you may know us as a language institute, but we also do other cultural aspects, such as education or sending students to the UK, arts and science, and that's where the Newton Fund comes in. And why the UK and why British Council is working a lot with science? Because now international collaboration has been very vital in doing research. The UK, as you can see from the statistics, shows that 48% of the publications from the UK are produced with international collaborators, and 72% of researchers in the UK are internationally mobile. And British Council, as we have over 100 offices around the world, we're able to foster collaborations and mobility among UK and countries. So the Newton Fund was launched in 2014, a very big UK government research funding, one of the biggest of its kind, over the course of 5 years to give research the opportunities to work in the UK and also in the partner countries. The Newton Fund is given to only 15 countries around the world, and Thailand is, of course, one of them, and we have a few neighboring countries offering Newton Fund as well, such as Malaysia, Philippines, Indonesia, and Vietnam. So this is how the Newton Fund works. So as it is such a big project, a lot of funding, there are delivery partners or partners helping the UK government to run the project. So we have, for example, Research Council UK, Royal Academy of Engineering, Royal Society of Chemistry, Met Office, British Academy, and of course, we're here doing the British Council side. So how does it work? So there are 12 programs, and today I'm going to give you information about the 5 programs which you in this room will be eligible to apply. We started in 2014, worked with over 71 universities in Thailand and UK and over 470 researchers. This year is our third year. Our calendar year starts in April, so now we're in the first few months of the third year, and we're doing all the 5 programs from PhD, professional development, researcher link, STEM education, and institutional link. And I have with me today from the panel our UK Newton alumni, Dr. Siri Penn, who is granted 3 out of the 5 programs, and Dr. Tuisak here as well from Mahidol University working on cancer. So if you have any questions or suggestions or want suggestions on how to apply for the programs, you can ask our alumni. But the Newton Fund doesn't just give the funding to researchers. What we have to do is we have to find a Thai partner who also give half of the funding. So therefore, out of the 5 programs, we work with 6 Thai organizations. Therefore, the Newton Fund concept becomes a work between Thai and UK government. So you are granted both of the country's funding. So we work with TRF, STI, the Ministry of Education, IPST, Office of Vocational Education, and Office of Basic Education Commission. And these are how it works in separating the projects. So TRF looks after three of the projects, while STI and the OHEC, Office of Higher Education Commission, works on institutional links, and STEM Education is the Ministry of Education. So the first program that we offer is called the PhD placement for scholars and supervisors. As it is co-funded by the TRF, this program is eligible for TRF scholars or supervisors. So the concept is for supervisors, if you're a supervisor under the TRF program, you can apply for the funding to go to the UK for up to 2 weeks to begin collaboration. You do not need to have students under your supervision. You can go to the UK to begin initial conversations so that once you have established a collaboration, you can later bring in your students or advise them. So it's how you start or form links. So that's we give about 2 weeks scholarship. But for scholars, those who are TRF scholars will get to go to abroad for 6 months under the TRF scheme. But with Newton Fund, we top up another 6 months. So you get to go to the UK, but you have to go to the UK for, you get to go to one year. And these are the list of universities and collaborations that were granted in the first and second year. So there are a few of them. The second program is called the Researcher Links Workshop and Travel Grants. How it works is that if you already have, for workshop, if you already have a research topic that you would like to work on, and you have a partner in the UK, and what you want to do is you want to build a young generation of early career researchers to know more about these topics, you can apply for the grant to conduct a workshop in Thailand for up to 5 days. And you can apply for this funding to get 2.5 million baht. And this allows you to bring researchers from Thailand for up to 20 people and researchers from the UK for up to 20 people. And this is a great platform or a starting platform for you to build in networks and collaborations for the future as well. However, if you do not have an established link to start a workshop, you can apply for what is called the travel grant. The travel grant is a 1 to 6 month opportunity to go to the UK, or you can invite UK researcher to come to your lab to do research and then to work with you. It's a two-way exchange, and it's a short term, so you don't have to go for a year, but you can go to a minimum of 1 month. And what's special about the Newton is we usually accept various topics from social sciences. So we have Dr. Silipen doing languages, or for example, Dr. Teresa here doing cancer. So we accept from various topics as well. These are some past topics of the travel grants. We also have a special collaboration with those who are working in chemistry, where we work with another Newton Fund delivery partner to fund workshops or travel grants working on chemistry. So we have an extra money for those group. Here is just an example of how the workshop works. This is King Mongkut Technology of Thornbury and University of Manchester working on drones. The third program is called the Professional Development and Engagement. This is a soft skill training for mid-career researchers, mean researchers who graduate PhD 5 to 10 years, and project officers. So it is a training in Thailand to how to write research proposal or how to write for big grants, and go to the UK for up to 1 week to visit various universities to start any links and to do training. So those of you who are wondering how now you're very interested and have, you know, a research work but no collaboration yet, you can join this program for you to be able to know how to write for bigger grants, for example, the Newton Fund or other EU grants. We also have project officers or your officers in your universities, administrators, so they can learn how to write grants or help you in terms of managing grants and all the budgeting. This is our first year mid-career researcher, Ajahn from Khonkan U, whose work is on the HD drive, the hard disk drive. The fourth program is our institutional link. This is a bigger grant than the workshop. What it gives you is that it builds on your existing, you must have an existing, quite a strong collaboration or research work already. And this grant gives you up to 1 to 2 years of funding to strengthen the grant, whether you want to do a series of workshops throughout the year, any exchange, a conference. So it gives you 1 to 2 years to build on your research work to make it stronger. And then you have an opportunity to decide your own research or in your own project. The last project is called the STEM Education. So this one we work mostly with the Ministry of Education. But what you can be involved is, as I assume most of you are probably from the STEM career or research, you can become STEM ambassadors. What STEM ambassadors are is that people who work in the STEM career go to school to inspire students to become interested in, career in science, technology, engineering, and maths, and they can know that there are other things to do than being a doctor or an engineer. So we have we've started this with IPST, and we trained a group of 200 STEM ambassadors and went to school, and we have one STEM ambassador here just teaching kids how to use material. So it's a model from the UK. The UK has over 30,000 STEM ambassadors in their country who go to schools on various occasions to talk about STEM education. And we also work with school directors. Now, how can the British Council and Newton Fund support you in finding a partner in the UK? As you realize that almost all, except the professional development, you must have some sort of partnership or an idea of what you want to do in UK. If you haven't had any establishment set up yet, you can work with the international unit where you can email them your CV or your intention to start any collaboration with the UK, and they will try to match you with a partner in the UK. And this could be something that's helpful because the international unit acts like OHEC in Thailand, where they work with various universities. So you can go to email to newton@international.ac.uk to tell them the programs that you want to apply to. They are very familiar with the Newton because they work only for the Newton Fund. Area of research, your abstract, and your CV. And if they're successful, they can match you with a partner or introduce you in partnerships. And for writing for the Newton Fund, as the Newton Fund is the part of the Official Development Assistance, or ODA, your application must reflect how your project is sustainable and how it will impact or important to Thailand or the UK in the future. Therefore, it is not just about telling about the background of your project, but looking more of how supporting you will then benefit to Thailand. And this is the challenge of researchers in writing for the Newton Fund, because it's looking at how, for example, it will help in sustainable development and how your impact can be measured. So looking at these questions, these are the questions that will be asked in the application, and you can see we're very open that to show all the questions for you so that you can prepare for this before you apply. For the open call, as now it's very good timing, we've just started year three. We've open call for institutional link already in April, and it will end in June. The next round will be researcher links opening in July, and for professional development and PhDs will have openings in May. So usually quite a few time for you to prepare. For institutional links and researcher links, it will go through UK selection process, means that your application will be scored by a UK expert panel. So if you're working in social sciences, you tick that you want a social science panel to grade your application. If you're a science, then you tell you it will divide into engineering, biology, and various others, so that it the those who grade your applications are experts in the field of their work. So you get about 2 to 4 months online application, 10 weeks of UK selection process, and it comes back to the Thailand, where our partner will select Thai expert panel to grade your application, and then we will announce. So if you apply for the April call, you get your result by the end of the year, and if you apply for July, then early next year. So it's quite a long process. But for other programs like PhD and professional development, the time is shorter, where you cut out the UK selection process as everything is graded in Thailand. For conditions on Newton Fund, Newton Fund is a non-binding scholarship, so you don't have to come back to pay for this. So it's totally up to your organization if they will allow you to go, or you have to discuss with them if you're already a scholar at, for example, NASDA, if you will be able to allow to go for another top-up of 6 months for travel grants, for example. But we have a few biotech scholars who got travel grants, and they had no issues. So that should be fine. And majority of the research field are sciences and social sciences. And most of the programs have different completion dates. So you have to just look out for the dates. What's important is that you need letter from host university. So you need host and home. So your Thai institution and your UK institution. So if you're thinking of applying and then you didn't see that you have to upload the letter, then this might take some time to prepare. So you have to prepare the letter to be uploaded into the program for it to be accepted. Only government body research institutes are higher education can apply. So any companies cannot apply. And you cannot reapply for the Newton Fund. So you can plan your own research career with the Newton Fund. You can start off with travel grant, then apply for a bigger workshop and an institutional link. So you can apply for various programs, and some program can reapply. So you can apply for a workshop, for example, 2 times. So that's the Newton Fund. That's the 5 programs under the Newton Fund where researchers are eligible to apply. Here is another of our science work under the British Council, where if you're a scientist, you can join our FameLab program, where we also work here with NSTDA on speaking science in just 3 minutes to make it interesting. So it's a competition for any early career researchers if you're interested to apply. There's also opportunities. For example, we work with Inspiring Science. This is another work that British Council does with the primary and secondary school students to develop materials, teaching science teaching materials to be used online for teacher reference. Another upcoming event that we will have is called the Newton Fund Information Day on 8th of July. You will hear about the 12 programs under the Newton Fund, and what's special is that we have invited one of the panels from the UK to come teach or do a workshop on proposal writing. So if any of you are interested, you could do this as a professional development and one day apply for the Newton Fund. And we have opportunities for networking as well, because on the 9th of July, we have a UK exhibition. So we have 40 universities flying from the UK. So it will be opportunities to meet some academics, maybe, and colleagues from UK universities, although they may be international officers, but they could, of course, potentially introduce you to researchers as well. So any information that you need, you can apply for, you can go to our website, the British Council website, or you could go to the Newton Fund, where you will see all the 12 programs at newtonfund.ac.uk. So if the British Council website is quite on the bottom, where the red box here, that's where we advertise our Newton Fund opportunities. Yes. So if you have any question, you can contact our office in Siam Square, or you can send us an email at newtonfund@britishcouncil.or.th, or give us a call as well. So hopefully now it's the time of the year to apply for the UK grants, as it's just the beginning of the financial year. I hope that we'll see some applications from people from this room, and I hope that it's useful information. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Janya, for an excellent overview of the Newton Fund. Clearly a whole range of opportunities in that program for you. And as you say, you can start off with a small travel grant and then move you right through. You can reapply for a number of the programs. And also the timing is good. A number of calls are coming up, and you've also got the information day. So questions from you for Kunchanya about the Newton Fund? You must have covered everything, I think.
Our alumni and I will just be here, so if you have any questions, just let us
know. And also, I think Dr. Tawisak, are you staying as well? So talk to alumni or talk to Kunchanya, and you can get some information in the networking session at the end of the day. Thanks, Janya. Okay.